morning to one and all. Today, Peter's cards are present here to enact a play on Bishop's Candlestick that was written by Norman McKinney, where Aishivek is performing the role of Morris, Karthik as narrator, Abhinav as convict, Rohan as bishop, and Siddharth as champ. So this is how the play goes.
The bishop is a very generous and kind person. His brother lives with him in his house. His name is Sam. Only Sam and Morris are in Bishop's home right now. Morris is making soup.
Morris, when will the soup be ready?
Sir, just a few minutes.
You lazy fellow. You must not have lit the fire properly.
Sir, it was you only who lit the fire.
Sam feels ashamed.
Okay, just leave it. By the way, it is 11 p.m. and still my brother has not reached. Do you know where has he gone?
Yes, sir.
Then why didn't you tell me?
Sir, you never asked it.
Okay, just leave it. Tell me, where has he gone?
Sir, actually has gone to meet my mother.
Wait, what? Why has my brother gone to meet your mother this late?
Sir, he asked me about my mother's health, so I told him that she is very ill. So he has gone to meet her now.
How generous is my brother?
Sir, the soup is ready.
You go bring the silver salt cellar. I will serve.
Sir, they have already been sold.
Sold? What do you mean by sold? How and when?
Sir, actually the bishop told me to sell them to Michael, who used to praise them. So I sold them.
What was going on in his mind?
Actually, sir, a tenant, Mary, was unable to pay her rent. So the landowner threatened her to leave the house immediately if she was unable to pay it till tomorrow. So in order to help her, the bishop sold the silver salt cellar.
Sam then thought to himself, I haven't bought anything in months, and there, my brother is wondering about paying other people's rents.
The bishop enters the house. On seeing his brother's sad face, he asked,
What happened, Sam? Did Morris break the dishes?
No, Morris didn't do anything.
You can go home now. Your mother is recovering well, and I will keep praying for her. So let me bring you a muffler.
So take my muffler.
Thank you, sir.
Sam gives the soup to Bishop and exclaims,
Are you insane? You went to see other people in such cold? They just pretend to be sick so that you go to meet them.
But it's a good thing only. They want to meet me.
One day you will suffer.
But that's a good thing only. I am helping others.
People are fooling you. Today you sold the silver salt cellar and then tomorrow you will send this candlestick.
No, I will never do that. These were given by our mother on her deathbed.
Bishop's candlesticks were made of silver and were really expensive. Sam then goes to his room to sleep. Bishop burns the firewood and starts reading a book.
A convict came to his house and threatened him with a knife. He was a fugitive who had recently ran from a jail.
Don't scream, otherwise I'll kill you.
What happened, brother?
Give me food. I haven't eaten all day.
The food is in the cupboard and the keys are with my brother.
Sit down. It's my order. Do you think I am a fool?
I wish the cupboard was unlocked. I and my brother are alone in this house.
Okay, go bring the keys, but don't try to be oversmart.
Bishop then goes to Sam's room.
Wake up, Sam. A needy person has come here.
Now don't even let me sleep peacefully. Wait, I am coming.
Sam gets scared. Bishop takes the keys from Sam and brings wine and pastry to the convict. The convict throws the fork and says,
Fork? We didn't use this in the jail.
What? You came from jail?
Yes. Any doubt? I am a thief. Aren't you afraid of thieves?
I'm really sorry for them.
And who are you, man?
I am Bishop.
Bishop, the ones who do religious activities?
Yes. Sam, go to sleep.
Earlier I was a man, but now I am a number. 1574 letter. Long ago I used to live with my wife in a small hut. Her name was Emma. We didn't have food and she was suffering from fever. So I went to steal, but eventually got caught by the cops. They sentenced me to 10 years. On the day of my sentencing, I came to know that my wife was no more. The jail was then like a hell for me. The guards in the jail used to beat me badly and give me dirty food containing insect. Now 6 weeks ago, they forgot to tie me and I ran away. Since then, I am stealing food and surviving.
Both of them get emotional.
You have suffered a lot. Now you should take some rest. I am bringing a blanket for you.
When Bishop goes to bring the blanket, the convict starts looking around the room.
Wow, this candlestick looks expensive. I can sell it for a very good price.
So, you're looking at this candlestick? This was given by my mother. Now you can go to sleep.
Bishop then goes to sleep.
Should I steal this or not? On one hand, the bishop has treated me with love and kindness. But I also want to start a new life.
He gives it a deep thought and finally steals the candlestick.
What? Who was there? Where is the candlestick? Wake up, brother. The convict has stolen the candlestick. He shouldn't be far. Call the police right now.
I don't want him to go to jail again.
Hey, what's the matter? Why are you running? I knew this candlestick. It's Bishop's.
No, you come with me.
Police comes to Bishop's house with the convict.
I got you right handy.
Who's there?
Wait, let me see.
Okay.
I found this man on my way and during checking, I found this candlestick with him. Then I remembered that it belongs to you. He is the culprit and now I am taking him to jail.
Please wait. He is my friend. I have gifted him it to him.
The sergeant releases the convict and continues patrolling.
What the hell was that?
Sam, go to your room.
He will cheat you again.
Go to your room at once.
Fine, but I am taking this candlestick with me.
No, keep this candlestick on the table and go.
Sam keeps the candlesticks and anxiously goes to his room.
Thanks. I'm very grateful to you for saving me.
Fine, but what's the plan now?
I'll be leaving for Paris tonight.
Wait, aren't you forgetting something? Take this candlestick with you. You need it more than me.
No, I can't keep it.
Please take it. Accept it as a small gift from me.
Okay, thank you so much. You change me back to human from a number.
No problem. Remember me as a temple of living God. Sure.
They bid each other goodbye and convict leaves for Paris.
This is how the story ends, and this was our enactment. We hope you liked it.